This is the Ninjutso Katana gaming mouse. This one is extremely light and it is pretty similar to the Logitech G Pro Wireless, but only in look alone. Like, it looks kind of similar, but this mouse is absolutely huge. Like, if I turn both of these around, you can see that just by its footprint alone, this is a large mouse. Because the G Pro Super Light, I would definitely consider to be like a medium-sized mouse, but this one sits firmly in the large category. More or less, imagine the G Pro Super Light, but a much wider flare at the back, and then the tapering on the sides. It feels like the G Pro Super Light is almost fully flat on its sides, but as you look at the Katana, it does curve out quite a bit, so your thumb kind of rests on an angle, where on the G Pro Super Light, your thumb rests kind of flat. So that is a pretty big difference in the shape, I think, and it is very unique. There really aren't a ton of mice that I've felt recently that flare outward toward the bottom as drastically as this mouse. Typically, they flare more inward, but this one, I find it to actually be pretty comfortable. Like, this is pretty nice to use. The side buttons are pretty similar to the G Pro Super Light as well. They're also extremely easy to hit. But these are some Kale 8.0 switches for the primary clicks, and they do feel extremely crispy. It's a TTC encoder that is very well lubed, and there's no rattle at all. Speaking of rattle, the build quality of this mouse is absolutely insane. Like, I took a look at a Zowie FK series mouse recently. It was the FK1C, I believe, and that mouse had some unbelievable build quality. And this one, honestly, it is a pretty solid rival to something of that quality. Like, it is very good. Now, something that this mouse does a ton better than any Zowie mouse is the fact that these mouse skates are extremely good. They call them the assassin skates or something like that, I want to say, or maybe it's the assassin cable, I don't know. But the PTFE skates that they use are really good. This is an extremely smooth glide. I would definitely say these are some A tier mouse feet. The cable, on the other hand, I don't really think that the cable is that great. Like, it is pretty stiff, but as soon as you throw this cable in a mouse bungee, you really don't have any issues at all. I use the Pulsar mouse bungee. I'll have that link in the description for you guys. It just attaches right to your monitor, and that's how I have been using this mouse with no issues. But as long as you don't have too much cable, it's not going to get in your way, and it's very firm, especially really close to it. So when you use it with the bungee, you don't come into contact with any bits of the cable at all. So it's a pretty uninterrupted and seemingly wireless feel when you're using this mouse. Now, as far as downsides of this mouse, there's no software, if you consider that a downside, so you don't get like super fine DPI control, but you do have a button on here for the pulling rate of the mouse and also the DPI. So you can set your DPI stages manually and you don't have to worry about messing with software, which is a pro. One of the last things I want to talk about with the Katana is just the sheer size of this mouse. Like, it is a massive mouse. This thing is huge. So if you don't have huge hands, you're probably not gonna like this. And when I say huge, I mean like anything that's around like 19 by 9 centimeters, which is the size of my hand, or bigger. Because if your hands are any smaller than that, you're probably gonna have a pretty hard time using this mouse. Like, look at this mouse in comparison to the Orochi V2. Like, this mouse is absolutely insane how massive it is. And even if you're looking at something like the Cone Pro, the grip on the Cone Pro is a lot smaller than the grip on the Katana. Like, when I grip the Katana, I can definitely tell that my grip is definitely pretty wide, but my grip on the Cone Pro, to be honest, is pretty narrow. My ring finger and my thumb feel like they're a little bit closer together than they do on the Katana. On the Katana, they definitely feel like they're pretty far out, and I believe that's due, again, to the shape of the side of the housing of the mouse. So if it was flat, I could definitely say that it would be more comparable to the Cone Pro. But if you're looking for a medium-sized mouse, I definitely will look at the G Pro Super Light or the Origin 1X if you're looking for more of an ergo shape. In terms of feeling the hand, this one is pretty unique. Like, I haven't felt another mouse that was pretty similar to this one. And really, what I want to see from this mouse, I want to see two things. I want to see a smaller version of this mouse that's probably a solid 15 to 18% smaller than this. And I also want to see a wireless one for that extra 20 bucks that's very similarly priced to the Origin 1X, because this mouse is a great mouse at 80 bucks. It's pretty comfortable, great build quality. I would like to see a wireless version of this one. Even before we see a wireless version of the full size one, I want to see a slightly smaller version of this mouse that also happens to be wireless for about 80 bucks. Like, that would be the thing that I'm most interested in seeing from Ninjutso next with this symmetrical shape, because this is a pretty unique feeling shape. I do like it quite a bit. Like, this is pretty nice to use, but you just have to have monstrously huge hands. But otherwise, that is going to be it for this video. If you guys enjoy, feel free to drop a like and subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. I want to thank you again for watching. I will have the katana link in the description below if you guys want to check out this mouse. But again, if you don't have huge hands, you're probably not going to like it that much. But I did enjoy it. I was smacking while playing with this mouse. Performance wise, it is very good. I want to thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.